EPO is a very naturally occurring hormone. What happened was that sports scientists realized that people with anemia were taking EPO because EPO is a hormone that occurs in the body. And the purpose of EPO is to send a message to the bone marrow to produce more red blood cells, to release them into circulation. It naturally occurs. But of course, when they realized the purpose of anemia, the medication for anemia, sports people then started taking it. But if you do breath holding, if you have reduced blood flow to the kidneys or to the liver, it actually stimulates EPO. So you can stimulate your own production of EPO. People with obstructive sleep apnea who are stopping breathing during their sleep, they have high EPO. That's known. And once they go on to a CPAP machine, their EPO levels start to drop. Because the whole thing with sleep apnea is often that the change in the blood gases are actually protecting the individual. The person with sleep apnea is holding their breath during their sleep. It's a massive stress to the body. Their oxygen levels are dropping, but their carbon dioxide levels increase. Their carbon dioxide levels increase, cause a right shift of the oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve, so they're getting more oxygen to the cells to help counter the desaturation. At the same time, their body produces EPO. The human body is so intelligent. If you deprive the body of oxygen, the body will try and counter that. So what we're doing is using breath holds to tap into that. But breath holds is only part of it. So EPO stimulates the proliferation and maturation of the bone marrow cells, and it'll happen pretty quickly. Results show that EPO concentration increased by 24%. It peaks at 3 hours, and it returns to baseline 2 hours later. It lasts for about 5 hours.